The first reading taken from the Book of Wisdom, chapter 18, verses 6 to 9, is an eye-opener to all of us because it gives a short summary of the Old Testament, the Book of Exodus, chapter 11 and 12. God promised the ancestors and they believed. They had faith. They thought that God's promises will be fulfilled. And that is why when the angel of the Lord was striking the Egyptian firstborn beast and man alike, the small group of Israelites were preparing the Passover meal. And why that Passover meal? They had a promise that they would go to the promised land, that they would be liberated from the land of Egypt, and they would be taken to the promised land. But then, dear friends, when we look at the history of these Israelites who left Egypt that day for almost 40 years, many of them could not make it to the promised land, including Moses. And that is why in the second reading we have a fantastic reflection by the author of the letter to the Hebrews when he says, the 11th chapter, he opens with these words: faith is the assurance of the things hoped for and a conviction of the things not seen. Faith is the assurance of the things hoped for and conviction of the things not seen. And that is why he continues in those chapters 11, 12 and 13. Beautiful explanation of Noah, Abraham, Moses and the ancestors, even coming to the life of Jesus. That's why we find Noah. He just believed what the Lord said. Prepare an ark. Abraham was asked, go from this land to a new land. He did not know what was the new land. He was wandering Aramaic. So he did not reach that land. What was that land? We never know. And Sarah was promised that at her old age there would be a son born. And God kept that promise. Moses, when he was asked at the burning bush, go to Egypt and bring those people who are enslaved there to the promised land. Moses said, I am not capable. I am not qualified. I am not able to talk. How can I bring these people? They are a rebellious people. Promise which was made, not fulfilled materially here on earth. But then, dear friends, we have to add this reflection to our own life. I will give you a short history of my own life. You know, when I was 12 years old, I remember, I go back to my own childhood days, I used to run early in the morning, getting up at 5 o'clock, run to the church to serve mass, like an altar servant. And I was hoping that great things will happen. And I decided on my own to become a priest. I'm still on the way. Promises are not fulfilled. Now I'm completing 30 years of priesthood. The promises God has made are not fulfilled. When they will be fulfilled? Dear friends, this applies to all of you, including me. We are all on the way, and the promise that made by our God in baptism. Today we will be having these two children baptized. And what is that promise? Promise of the kingdom of God. It may not realize. Of course, when good things come, we have to accept them. Riches come, health comes, wealth comes. Okay, we will accept it. But that is not God's kingdom. When you are the rich and richest, when you are healthy, healthier, healthiest, that is not God's kingdom. And therefore, Jesus very clearly mentions in the gospel, have purses that do not wear out. Have purses that do not wear out. Do you have a wallet in your pocket? Do you have a purse? They wear out. But Jesus says, have purses that do not wear out. And I remember something in this connection. Just 3 days ago, I went to Robson Street to buy a wallet. You know, my old wallet had worn out. Therefore, I wanted to buy a wallet. So I went and entered a shop, and there were many wallets, very expensive. There were Italian brand, $125, too expensive. So then I went to other shops, and then I found a nice Canadian shop where they were selling Canadian items, maple syrup, and keychains, bags, and so on. Then I entered and I said, I want a wallet. Here, you can find all that you want. And I searched and found out a nice wallet, which I really liked, pure leather. When I looked, it was costing $23. But then there was inscription put 50% discount. Very happy. 50% discount. I got it just for $11 or $12. I got it, I came to my car, I emptied my old worn out wallet and put all the cards inside, and then inside I found an etiquette made in, look behind, in India. Can you imagine? I am buying a wallet in a Canadian shop where they are selling all items Canadian. An Indian goes and buys a wallet thinking that it is Canadian, but it is Indian wallet. I am very happy. I am very happy. Even wallets are sold in Canada, Indian wallets. They are good, good quality. I like it very much. That's why Jesus says, you need to have a wallet or a purse that does not wear out. That is one thing. Now, another good news. It's a good news or bad news, I do not know. You can judge it. You know, I use WhatsApp. How many of you use WhatsApp? You know, that's a nice app. You know, this is a wonder. I do not know. This is really a wonder. My brothers and sisters at home, they click each and every photograph that is in my home. A dog sleeping, cat eating, my nieces and nephews playing, and my mother, my brothers, when they touch a tree or eat a fruit, they click a photo and send it immediately. Oh my God. Then I go down to Georgia Street and click some photos, I send them. We do not miss each other, you know, because of WhatsApp. Okay? If you want more information, please call my secretary, she will tell you what it is. And then I got a nice video clip. And that video clip, you know, there was such a lot of police and lot of people. They were counting money, stacks of money. And the video, they moved to a place and there was a homeless man, dead. And they were counting. I watched the whole video. You know, what is the conclusion? This homeless man, who was carrying loads of things in his cart, died on the road, and he had such a lot of cash, and they were counting. You know what is the total? You will be totally surprised how much money he had. In comparison, in Canadian dollars, more than $200,000. And I was thinking, my God, if I had that money, I can have a beautiful life. He could have a beautiful life. He could have a nice condo and live comfortably, but still he was continuing to beg. Now, what is the meaning of these things that happen in the world, dear friends? When Jesus says, the kingdom of God will be yours. But what we have to do? We have to sell off all our possessions and give alms. Now, what is literally, what does that mean? It does not mean that we have to go home and sell everything and give to the poor and wander about like homeless people. That would be illogical, unreasonable. What does that mean? You know, that's why Jesus concludes so beautifully that particular paragraph. Where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. That means our treasure is not in this world. You know, just sometimes thoughts come to my mind. Let us think about Bill Gates. Let us think about Warren Buffett. Now, these are the richest guys, billionaires. Now, have you heard ever they have told oh, I have billions of dollars and that's enough for me. I don't want to invest anymore. No, no. This is enough. Billions of dollars. That is enough for them for another entire hundreds of generations. No, I don't want any more money. I'm not going to invest anymore. But they keep on investing. They keep on investing. Of course, they are doing a lot of charity also. But a lesson we can learn from them is this. Human heart is never satisfied with the things of this world. And that's why Jesus very clearly says, dispossession means that we have to share whatever we have, whether it is money, wealth, time, talents, resources, whatever we have, we can share. And that is what is preparing our wallet or purse that does not wear out. That means the good things that you do remain. Like that beggar who had $200,000. He could have shared it with himself or with his family or with some of his friends. He could have made some people at least happier. But then all that money goes to the government. The same thing applies to all of us. Dear friends, we have time. You know, dispossession of time is, I can use my time for myself all the time. I can watch TV, I can go for a walk, I can have pleasure trips. But then can I sacrifice little bit of time for my neighbor, for my mom, for my dad, for my brother, for my sister, for my neighbors, for someone who is sick, who is ailing, who wants company, who is homebound? Can I do that? That is dispossession of myself. Giving alms is not only money, but I can give my time. I can give my talents. I can share the resources God has given me. And that is where faith comes. Dear friends, all of us are making this journey where it is not to a town or city or to a treasure in this world, but to God's kingdom. And that is where we have to go, where we have to march. And that's what Jesus very clearly says here in this gospel passage. We all must be ready. And that's why once Martin Luther was asked, if the world were to end tomorrow, what are you going to do? He said, well, if the world is going to be ended tomorrow, I will continue to plant apple trees and I will continue to pay back my debts. And Francis of Assisi was asked, what will you do if the world were to end tomorrow? He said, I will continue to work in my garden. I will continue to hoe my garden. You know, if we are not afraid, dear friends, we are not afraid. Because God's kingdom is within us. No matter what happens, I may be poor, I may be sinner, I may be the worst kind of guy. But if I fix my attention on God's kingdom, that means I am not of this world, I am meant for another world, I am born for a purpose, I am born for a goal. And that's why whatever I can make beautiful in this world, that remains. Good works, good works, good works. That's what St. Teresa of Avila, at the end of her great writing, The Interior Castle, explaining the visions and all sorts of adventurous journeys of the soul. Finally, she says, good works, good works, good works. If we can do that, very easy. You know, what are the good works we can do? Simple, ordinary things. Without having great expectations and ambitions. You know, ambitions are good. Hard work is good. But then good intentions and good works that lead us to God's kingdom. Dear friends, whatever we do right now must flower into heaven. And that's why heaven is nowhere else. Heaven is here. And that's why Jesus said, do not look for God's kingdom here, there, far away. The kingdom of God is within you. If you have good works, good intentions, if you are generous, kind, forgiving, loving, understanding, these are the good works that contribute, and that is the purse you have, which will never wear out. Where the moth does not destroy, the thief does not break in to steal. Dear friends, this is the message we have this Sunday. Let us ask the Lord during this Holy Eucharist to inspire us to go deeper into this Gospel passage so that we may understand what the writer of the letter to the Hebrews says. Faith is the assurance of the things hoped for and conviction of things not seen. Where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. God bless you.